Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are doing good and enjoying your studies. This is Devangi ma'am here. I am back with the part 3 of grammar lesson number 2, that is pronouns. Till now in the previous two videos, we have already understood 5 different kinds of pronouns, starting from personal, possessive, reflexive, emphatic and demonstrative. In this video, we are going to finish up with the lesson by understanding the last 3 kinds of pronouns. Let us begin with the 6th kind, that is interrogative pronouns. Now the word interrogative itself suggests that these pronouns would be the words that would be asking questions. You all must have known that interrogative sentences are the one that ask questions. Similarly, if at all there is any kind of interrogative pronoun, then these would be the words which will ask different kinds of questions or will try to inquire about any person or thing regarding which we do not have any information or we do not know about. So you can see and read it from this itself. Interrogative pronouns are question words used to inquire about person or thing we do not know about. So interrogative pronouns aise words hai जिसको यूज करके हम सेंटेंस में क्वेश्चंस पूछते हैं रिलेटेड टू अ पर्सन और अ थिंग जिसके बारे में हमें कुछ भी आइडिया या नॉलेज नहीं है. एन इंटरोगेटिव प्रोनाउन इज यूज्ड व्हेन आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस. इट टेक द प्लेस ऑफ सब्जेक्ट और ऑब्जेक्ट इन द सेंटेंस. अब ये जो इंटरोगेटिव प्रोनाउन वाले वर्ड्स है वो सेंटेंस में सब्जेक्ट या ऑब्जेक्ट का प्लेस ले सकते हैं डिपेंडिंग अपॉन कि वो किस नाउन के बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन पूछ रहे हैं. Now there are 5 main interrogative pronouns, which are what, who, whom, which, and whose. So as you can see here, these are the 5 interrogative pronouns. You can see the examples also given on the screen. What is the time here? What is that is trying to inquire or ask about the noun time. Then who writes poem here? Who is trying to ask question about the person who writes poem. Whom do you want to talk to? Here, whom is asking question regarding the person जिससे आपको बात करनी है. Fourth, which book do you want? Here, which is referring to the thing, the book that you want to read. Then fifth, whose watch is this? Here, whose is referring to the person जिससे भी ये watch belong करती है, जिसकी भी ये watch है. Now we will see how different interrogative pronouns are used and for what. Purposes. Here, interrogative pronoun list is given and for what particular purpose it is used. Let us see here. Which, when you have a limited choice, it is also used for various non-living objects or things. जब आपके पास choice limited होती है, you give options to people for that purpose. You ask which. Then what is used for asking general information. कोई भी चीज हो सकती है. Who is used when asking about a person and name. किसी भी person के बारे में जानना है, you use who at that time. Whom when you are again asking about a person या फिर उसका name, then also you can use whom. Whoever whenever you are not aware कि तुम किस person की बात कर रहे हो या किस person के बारे में जानना चाहते हो, so you signify or you lay emphasis on the fact कि whoever and you give a reasonable reason for it. By whoever has not submitted the homework, raise your hand. So here whoever person ki jisne apna kaam nahi kiya hai wo apna hand raise kar le. So whoever does not we do not know who that person is, but we try to specify it by giving a reasonable information about it. Moving further, we'll see some different examples here. Which one would you like? Which doctor did you see? What is your name? What did you wear? Etc. So from this we come to know that interrogative pronoun are the words that ask questions related to the noun, related to the subject that we are talking about in the sentence. It could be any person or even a thing. Now we'll begin with the next kind of pronoun, that is relative pronouns. Here relative pronouns are again the pronouns that take place of the noun. We know that this is the common basic function of the pronoun, that is to take the place of the noun. But why it is called relative here? It is called relative because its function is to relate back to something or someone जिसके बारे में हम सेंटेंस में बात कर रहे हैं. Whatever relative pronouns are there, जो भी words relative pronouns है, वो सेंटेंस में ये काम करते हैं कि वो हमें relate back करवाते हैं उस particular person या चीज से जिसके बारे में हम सेंटेंस में बात कर रहे हैं. And they sometimes even also function as conjunctions because they help in joining two sentences about the same person or the thing. Now here you can see again in the relative pronoun we have five types of words that are the part of relative pronouns. That is who, whose, whom, which and that. Here who, whose and whom is mostly used for people, living things, whereas which and that can be used for animals and different objects or things. Here as you can see the usage of who is given, different kind of relative pronouns usage is given. Who replaces the subject pronouns I, she, he, we and they. So ye unka jagah le leta hai and in the example it is used accordingly. This is the man who broke the window. So here the relative pronoun who is relating back to the man jisne window break kiya hai. Whose show possession or relationship. It tries to show कि हम जिस भी चीज की या पर्सन की बात कर रहे हैं वो किसका है या उस पर किसका ओनरशिप है या वो किस पर्टिकुलर पर्सन या चीज से बिलोंग करता है. She knew the family whose house we bought. So here whose is referring to the family. It is relating back to the family जिसका घर उसने खरीदा है. Whom replaces the object pronouns. Whom yani ki wo object ki place pe aata hai, yani at the place of the receiver of the action. Again it relates back to any kind of person only. They have found the lady whom they want to interview. Isko found kiya hai wo lady ko. Aur whom is relating back to that lady in the object's place jinko unhone find kiya hai jiska interview wo lena chahte the. Then which. It clauses that begin with which are almost always non-restrictive. Means उसमें कुछ limitation नहीं होता है. When you are using which as a relative pronoun, you can add up more information about the noun that you are talking about. As you can see in the example, my precious blue lamp, which was in the room, was broken. So here, which is relating back to the lamp, जो कि एक precious blue color ka hai and also it is in the room jo abhi toot gaya hai. Whereas in that, clauses that begin with that are almost always restrictive. Usme restrictive information hota hai, limited. You cannot share whole lot of information about the noun that you are talking about or relating back. The lamp that was in the room was broken. So you can understand the difference. Where which was used as a relative pronoun, even the additional information that the lamp was of precious blue color was given. Whereas where that is used as a relative pronoun, that particular information is not given. Only it is informed that wo lamp jo room mein tha wo toot gaya hai. Moving further, we will see how you can read it from here. Who, whose and whom is used for people, person. Whereas which and that is used for things and animals. That can also be used for people as well. So let us see some more examples. Who is used for people? The woman who called yesterday wants to buy the house. Here who is relating back to the woman jisko wo ghar khareedna hai, jisne kal phone kiya tha khareedne ke liye. Then which is used for things and animals. Did you see the letter which came today? So in this sentence which is referring, it is relating back to the letter, the thing jo ki aaj aaya hai. I love the puppy which is jumping at the kitchen. So again here which in the second sentence is relating to the puppy, an animal which is jumping in the kitchen. Then whose is used for possessions of people's animals. Here's a man whose opinion I respect. So whose is used for such people or animal or unke possession ke bare mein hum baat kar sakte hain. So here whose is relating to a man's opinion jisko tum respect karte ho. एक ऐसा ओपिनियन एक पर्टिकुलर पर्सन का जो तुम रिस्पेक्ट करते हो. देन इन द सेकंड एग्जांपल शी इज अ स्टूडेंट हुज हैंडराइटिंग इज द बेस्ट इन क्लास. सो हियर हुज इज रिलेटिंग टू द स्टूडेंट्स, द पर्टिकुलर स्टूडेंट जिसकी हैंडराइटिंग इज द बेस्ट इन योर क्लास. होम इज यूज्ड फॉर पीपल व्हेन द पर्सन इज द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द वर्क. पिछली स्लाइड में ही हमने देख लिया है दैट ऑब्जेक्ट इज द रिसीवर ऑफ द एक्शन. तो हुम ऐसे पर्सन या ऐसे नाम को रिलेट बैक करेगा जो कि एक्शन का रिसीवर है. द ऑथर हुम यू क्रिटिसाइज्ड इन योर रिव्यू हैज रिटन अ लेटर इन रिप्लाई. सो हियर हुम इज रिलेटिंग टू द ऑथर जिसने तुम्हारा क्रिटिसाइज रिसीव किया है. Then that is used for people, things and animals. That is used for all people, things as well as animals. You can see all the three examples given. The girl that we met in France has sent us a card. So here that is relating back to the girl or people जिसको तुम फ्रेंड्स में मिले थे, जिसने तुम्हें एक कार्ड भेजा है. We live in a ground floor flat that backs onto a busy street. So here that is relating to a thing which is a flat. Then do you like the cat that is sleeping underneath the table? So here that is relating to the animal, the cat, जो कि table के नीचे सो रही. So I hope you are clear with the relative pronouns. They relate back to the person or thing that you are talking about in the sentence. They are five in number. That is who, whose, which, whom, that. The last type of pronoun that we are going to study is indefinite pronoun. The word indefinite itself suggests something which is unidentified or unspecified in number. कोई ऐसी चीज या कोई ऐसा person जो हमें specifically पता नहीं है, वो कोई भी हो सकता है या फिर वो चीज कुछ भी हो सकती है, and in any number, whether one or more, we do not know. And even if we know whether in what number they are, singular or plural, we do not know who or whom they are. Indefinite pronouns show unspecified objects or people, whether in plural or in singular. So, ये ऐसे चीजें और लोग दिखाते हैं जो हमें पता नहीं है, और वो plural या singular दोनों हो सकते हैं. Indicate the entire noun or some of the noun or none of the noun. ऐसे pronouns जो होते हैं वो या तो एक पूरा noun दिखाते हैं, या फिर कुछ number of nouns दिखाते हैं, या फिर कोई भी noun नहीं दिखाते. Used when we want to refer to group of nouns without actually specifying who or how much. They are also used to refer to group of people without specifying or without pinpointing ki hum kiske bare mein specifically ya kis cheez ke bare mein baat kar rahe hain. We given below is the list of various indefinite pronouns, as you can read out from here: somebody, somewhere, anybody, nobody, etc. Moving further, we will see some examples. It's hard to say somebody is good, but still nobody can replace. So here, the indefinite pronoun somebody is referring to koi person jisko hum jante nahi hai, who is indefinite, who is unspecified. Sometimes I just need someone to talk to. So here again, someone is not specified. Bas wo jo person hai, usko koi chahiye baat karne ke liye. But kaun chahiye? That is not specified. Similarly, various more examples are given. You can take some time and read it. Moving further, here's additional list of indefinite pronouns, with so many indefinite pronouns singular in nature and how they are used as an example in a sentence. You can go through them. I'll just read out 2-3. We finally moved to another apartment. This is a singular indefinite pronoun. Which apartment? कौन से apartment में कौन सी जगह पे? That you are not aware about. बस एक दूसरे apartment में आप move हो चुके हो, shift हो चुके हो, and obviously you cannot shift into more than one apartment at a time. So that is why we can understand that it is singular in nature. But वो कौन सा apartment है? वो हमें नहीं पता है. It is not specified. Then each company is fighting to protect its own commercial interest. मतलब हर एक कंपनी जो है, हम सारी जो भी कंपनीज लड़ रही है, हम उनको इंडिविजुअली रेफर कर रहे हैं, वो लड़ रही है अपने अपने इंटरेस्ट बचाने के लिए. अब वो सारी कंपनीज कौन सी है, विच आर दो स्पेसिफिक कंपनीज दैट वी आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट. इनफ इज इनफ मीन्स अब बहुत हो गया है, बट क्या बहुत हो गया है, दैट वी आर नॉट नोइंग. Some more examples related to plural indefinite pronouns. Some words are both, few, fewer. Both are guilty, yani dono hi guilty hai. Two persons, so plural. A few of the justices voice their opposition, means jo bhi justice ke जूरी में है या कमिटी में है, उसमें से कुछ लोगों ने, फ्यू रिफर्स टू नंबर ऑफ, फ्यू नंबर ऑफ पीपल जिन्होंने अपनी आवाज उठाई अपोजिशन के खिलाफ. फ्यूअर आर स्मोकिंग दीज डेज, अगेन फ्यूअर इनडेफिनेट प्रोनाउंस आर रेफरिंग टू फ्यू पीपल, बट वो कौन है वी डू नॉट नो, कि उन्होंने अभी स्मोकिंग कम कर दिया है, छोड़ दिया है. सिमिलरली देर आर सर्टेन इनडेफिनेट प्रोनाउंस जो कि दोनों में यूज हो सकते हैं, सिंगुलर भी एंड प्लूरल भी. As you can see in the example, all of the newspapers were sold. So here you are talking about all the newspapers, but with specific ones that you are not knowing. कि सारे newspapers soak हो गए, गीले हो गए. Then any press is good press. कोई भी press ले लो, सारे अच्छे ही है. But with specific one you are not aware about. So I hope you all are clear with what indefinite pronouns are. They are such words which do not specify any kind of person or a thing. They just give information about either a particular individual or a group of person. इसके बारे में हम बात कर रहे हैं in a general and common way, but who they exactly are or what they exactly are is not specified. So I hope you are clear with the whole lesson of pronouns, how they take place of a noun, and what kind of different functions are played by them, and what kind of different information they show. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.